In this video, we're going to go over some questions and gotchas that might come up when merging accounts. The Merge Accounts tool is on the Accounts tab in the Tools section. When searching for accounts, make sure there's at least one identical word in each account name to pull up potential duplicates. Accounts that you may know to be duplicates, but which don't contain the same word in the title, will not come up in a search. If you have more than three accounts that need to be merged, you should merge three at a time until you have consolidated all of the information into one master account. The account that you select as the master will automatically keep its data from any hidden or read-only fields, such as account number or account site. These fields won't display during the merge process. If you have the Edit Read-Only Fields permission, however, you will be able to select which read-only field to keep without it defaulting to the master field. When selecting accounts to merge, keep in mind that you will also need the appropriate permissions, since you're essentially deleting all but the master account records. To merge two or more accounts, you will need to be a system administrator or the account owner on all accounts, or be above the account owner in the role hierarchy. Have delete permission on the account object. Or, in addition, if you're not the account owner, you must have the delete permission for accounts, and at least edit permissions for cases and opportunities. Any sharing rules, manual or otherwise, that apply to the accounts prior to merge will automatically be applied to the new master account. If an account has account team members, there are a couple things to keep in mind. First, the newly merged account will contain all account team members from all merged accounts. If you're not a system administrator, you may not be able to merge the accounts if one of the account team members has greater access to any of the related records, accounts, cases, or opportunities. In this case, you would need the Modify All Data permission to continue with the merge. If your organization has person accounts enabled, keep in mind that even if both person and business accounts come up in your search, you will not be able to merge these. Business accounts can only be merged with business accounts, and person accounts with person accounts. Additionally, if a person account has been enabled for the customer portal, it cannot be merged at all, including with another person account. If you're merging accounts associated with portal accounts, make sure that you have the Manage Users permission checked on your profile, or permission set. The associated contacts of portal accounts have to have the same portal type. For example, customer portal with customer portal. Contacts access to specific portals doesn't change, regardless of whether they're associated to multiple portals. If you need to merge a partner account with a non-partner account, make sure you set the partner account to the master account, and all portal contacts are associated to the master account. Partner account owners cannot be changed. When you merge accounts that have territories, manually assigned territories will be associated to the master account. Territory assignment rules will only run if the Evaluate This Account Against Territory rules on Save is checked by default on the associated page layout. Setting merged value of Exclude from Territory Assignments to True causes the following to happen. Territory rules will not be run, and existing territory associations will be removed. Territory rules only run if they are in an active state. One final gotcha is that your newly created merged account's creation date will display the created date of the oldest account that was part of the merge, while the last modified date will display the merge date. For more information, see the following topics in Salesforce Help, or visit the Salesforce Success Community at success.salesforce.com. And thanks for using Salesforce.